Hi again. So today we're going to continue talking about your IELTS preparation and your schedule for that. So please prepare such kind of schedule when you know your definite time, your definite day, definite date, and also definite place where you're going to get prepared. Right. If you ask me for a piece of advice, I will tell you that it is vital to get prepared every day. Let's have 6 days in a row for your preparation and one day off. So let's talk about your preparation days. My decision is. My hack maybe is to propose that it is nice to get prepared early in the morning. If mostly you get up at 7 a.m., it is better to get at 6 a.m. and you have 1 hour for your preparation, definite preparation. So please go to bed earlier. Please keep your promises. All right. So, because you're not going to cheat yourself, you're going to be honest with yourself because you are to achieve your goal with IELTS preparation, with your IELTS certificate. And also during the day, you may have 1 more hour for your preparation, and it is your decision to decide when it is convenient for you. Maybe during the day, maybe in the evening, maybe at 10 p.m. But it should be your private time when you have your preparation, your study. So, 6 days in a row, you have definite time, definite place, and definite date. So, you are going to prepare 6 days in a row and at least 2 hours will do you. On a daily basis, right? So I also propose that during 6 days you have your lessons, you gain the information, you take the information, you practice it. So you have a lesson, afterwards you practice it. Not only theory. If you get the theory, you wouldn't do anything good with it. Let me give you an example. I had my advanced second part with native speaker, Mr. Tim Wright. So he conducted lessons. We were groups of people of 10 students. Most of them were 9th, 10th grade students, and I am teacher. So I was the oldest, but the thing is not here. The thing that I want to express is he conducts the lesson. The teacher conducts his lesson, right? He conducts it equally. Everybody is involved into the lesson. We have our turn to give the answer, right? Everybody, we do the home assignment. But the thing is that practice plays better role. When we practice the theory, play it as a team or individually, we try to memorize it, we try to analyze when the things are used. For instance, there was a lesson devoted to onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is when sounds are done, when sounds imitating with words is expressed, like chuckle, cling cling. It is the key, right? Cling cling. What else? Shuffle, right? Okay. So, ding dong. This is the ring, right? There were some sounds imitations that I was challenged by, right? So I didn't know what to use, how to use it, because it was a little bit similar to my native languages imitations, so I just swept them, switch them, sweep them. So one day our teacher gave us the exercises, so we practiced them. Practice, practice, practice. And it turned out that that day I had to take my mini test devoted to our course once in 2 weeks, once in 4 lessons. We were given this opportunity to take the test, and I, due to my work, missed one of them. And that very day when we practiced this onomatopoeia, I wrote the test, and there were the questions devoted to imitation words. So I gained more points compared to other tests. Why? Because I practiced. Our theory was recycled as a practical lesson. So when you gain the information, you should practice it. You don't have a person to talk to? Imagine a person in front of you. Talk to a mirror. Talk to a video camera, okay? So this is the opportunity for you to utilize the knowledge that you gain in order to make it saved here in your brain.